Frost is very happy to present a fine group. Tomorrow came sooner than expected. I'd like you to welcome Captain Beyond.
Trying hard, got no one to help me. I got to make a
Thanks a lot. Just had a little problem over here with the guitar. Change instruments. Let's go distant sun. Let's sing off the first album called Dancing Madly Backwards. Oh, on a sea of air. Just adjusting the bass pedal. Adjust it, yeah?
Thank you. tower. Thank you very much. Nice to be back in Arlington once again. We were here last year, give or take a week or two, about a year ago. And nice to see the place packed. We go on to thing out the second album called Drifting in Open Space. I said, mic the lead guitar. That's what you need. You need a big mic in front of your amp there. Louder, right? Yeah! See,
yeah!
It sounds like a fly, right? Need to be louder. Mega death volume. Messed up over here, which as you'll notice by the flashlight, you'll see it being checked out. You just bear with us a moment, we'll be right with you. Just hook up another amp or something. Whatever you're smoking, keep blowing it this way. It's happening. Everybody exhale toward the stage. Mm-hmm. Once upon a time, in the land of Hushabai, around about the wondrous days of yore, they came across a sort of box, bound up in chains, and locked with locks, and labeled, "Kindly do not touch. It's war." A decree was issued round about, all with a flourish and a shout, and a gaily colored mascot tripping lightly on before. "Don't fiddle with this deadly box, or break the chains, or pick the locks. And please, don't ever mess about with war." Well, the children understood, for children happened to be good, and were just as good around the days of yore. They didn't try to pick the locks, or break into that deadly box, and never tried to play about with war. Mummies didn't either, sisters, aunts, nor grannies either, for they were quiet and sweet and pretty in those days of yore. Very much the same as now, not the ones to blame somehow for opening up that deadly box of war. But someone did. Someone battered in the lid and spilled the insides out across the floor. A sort of bouncy, bumpy ball made up of flags and guns and all the horror and the tears and the death that go with war. It bounced right out, went bashing all about and bumping into everything in store. And what was sad and most unfair was that it didn't really seem to care much who it bumped, or why, or what, or for. It bumped the children mainly, and I'll tell you this quite plainly, it bumps them every day, and more, leaves them dead, burned and dying, thousands of them sick and crying, because when it bumps, it's very, very sore. Now there is a way to stop the ball. It isn't very hard at all. All you need is wisdom. And I'm absolutely sure we could get it back into the box, bind the chains, and lock the locks. But no one seems to want to save the children anymore. Well, that's the way it all appears. For it's been bouncing around for years and years, in spite of all the wisdom whizzed since those wondrous days of yore. And the day they came across a box, bound in chains, and locked with locks, and labeled, "Kindly do not touch. It's war." Bobby Caldwell on drums.
Anybody remember that?
I'll tell you something. When we were over by a gentleman to serve, we were booked to do these gigs. Texas, and I'm not hyping you either because we've done it everywhere. Now, I think it's about the best audiences I've ever played for. No, no shit. No, I'm not kidding. What about the group giving a round of applause to the crowd here? No, I'm serious. If we can get you people up, then we might be able to do it on this one. Can we get it up? Let's do it!